got Nino Schurter's Scott Spark. We'll have a good look around it. Nino is 3 times world champion, 2-time Olympic medalist, so certainly knows what he's doing on a cross-country bike. First thing I notice is, you know, like most cross-country race bikes, it's just dripping in carbon. You've got carbon rims, carbon bars, carbon frame, obviously, seat posts, and even Nino on here has got prototype carbon steerer and crown on his DT Swiss fork, so that's pretty unusual. Also, the DT Swiss shock has got a carbon body on it, so everything pretty much, you know, cranks as well, dripping in carbon fibre. So something that I don't get to see a lot of is tubular tyres. I guess cross-country guys are relatively popular. Nino's got the Dugast tubs on here, 50 wide, and then that W is the compound. So pretty unusual tyres on here. Carbon rims, obviously super lightweight, super stiff. Going up to the bars, it's got the lockout that works the fork and the shock. So obviously super good for climbing. You can just whack that lever, get everything locked out. You see the foam grips? A lot of the cross-country guys run those. They're super light, they're glued onto the bar so they don't move. Obviously, virtually no weight on a foam grip. Garmin mount, pretty standard affair. The guys use those for training and for racing nowadays. A 1x11 system on here, so nice and light, nice and simple. I guess they might play around with chainring size depending on course, but running 1x11 all year. Got this DT Swiss fork with a carbon crown and steerer. That drops 160 grams off the weight compared to the normal crown and steerer setup. Also, they're slammed to 100 mil. Scott Sparks normally come with 120 mil forks, but it's bringing it right down on the front end to keep the bars really low, good for aggressive climbing. Also got these SKF seals on here. They're that's a motorcycle brand. I've not seen those before. A prototype Ritchey seat post on here with zero offset, so rather than the normal slight layback, he's got it straight up. Again, keeps that weight up towards the bars, that really helps for climbing. Super nice graphics on here, you see Swiss flag up the front, also on the back, with the rainbow stripes. Got to earn those things, you can't just be sticking them on your bike if you haven't won them. So overall, really nice looking bike. Attention to detail is there. You notice this little piece of tape on the seat post rather than just scratching a little line onto that post, you know exactly where to put it. You know, a little piece of tape shows you that. So, you know, little touches like that are pretty impressive. Looks really cool with the skin wall tires and really nice stealthy black paint job on that bike. Pretty cool. Cool, so we've checked out Nino's bike. Now we've got the main man himself. So Nino, you spend a bit of time on the Spark, but also hardtail as well. You ride that occasionally. I guess that depends on the course, does it?
Yeah, it depends on the course, and yeah, we have now the perfect option of having two awesome bikes. The Scale is one of the fastest hardtails, and now the Spark, especially now with the new shock and fork, it's an amazing bike, and
yeah,
it's cool to have both really options.
Good. You go for the 100 mm fork on the front, just yeah. Or you like the low front end for climbing?
Yeah, I really like the low front end. You see it as well on my handlebar. It goes even a bit down.
Yeah. Would you say that you're fussy with setup? Does your mechanic have a hard time in the races trying to keep you happy? Or do you think it's on there, it's fine, I'll ride it?
I'm actually pretty... If I don't need to have it everything exactly,
right? Yeah.
So
you don't have your tape measure right, making sure your brake levers at the right spot, or
yeah, I'm sure I'm a bit picky, but there are other riders they are taking more focus on that. It's anyway, if you change from hardtail to full suspension, you need to a bit adapt. It's never the same. Yeah. As well, if the position is exactly the same, it's still different. So. Now with the time, I got used to change me quite fast on the bike.
When you go for a ride at home, so not racing, not training, just going for a good fun ride, what bike would you choose to ride for that?
Then it's probably the Genius LT.
Yeah.
yeah, we have
flat pedals.
No flat pedals, but I really yeah, enjoy to ride nice trails, and if it's just for fun, go climbing up a nice mountain and then have a have a nice descent. Yeah, we have perfect trails for that in Switzerland. So then I go for the Genius LT.
Oh, cool, As you can see, Nino runs the standard seat post on here. If it was me, I'd stick a whopping great heavy dropper post on there. But check out our seat up versus seat down video up here, or have a look at Simon's how to ride a hardtail faster down here. Don't forget, you can always click on me or the big red fire engine to subscribe to GMBN.